People tend to think of migrations as linear journeys. The migration of the painted lady butterfly is actually more like a fluid network. For the past few years, I've been following the painted lady butterflies all over the world, photographing what they see on their journey.
Every spring, millions of painted lady butterflies travel north from the southern fringes of the Sahara, up as far as the Arctic Circle. They cover 14,000 kilometers in a circular journey that spans 8 to 10 generations. Morning.
Good morning.
How are you?
I'm well. How are you?
Good. This year, Europe has suffered a particularly strong drought, so painted lady butterfly may have been affected by it. So we're going to go high up in the mountains, up to 2,000 meters, there where the glaciers are. I think we have better chances to find them there.
Painted lady butterflies have been migrating since before people dominated the landscape. As climate change alters weather, each unusual storm, drought, heat wave, or freeze ripples through their migration.
This is the main host plant of a painted lady. This is where the females put the eggs and the caterpillars feed. It hasn't barely rained in the area, so it's too dry for them to feed on them. Butterflies are pollinators, migratory butterflies. They carry pollen from one continent to another, so they're connecting ecosystems that are thousands of kilometers apart. As climate continues to change, will they stop migrating? Will they migrate further, or will they migrate less? Will they change completely their migration routes? We don't know. It is a mystery.
Migrations everywhere are changing. 7.8 billion people living on Earth are triggering many of these changes. In my photographs, the painted lady butterflies link diverse people in diverse places. They are a metaphor both for the interconnected world and our responsibility to care for it.
We live in an ever more connected world with very complex and fragile logistics networks, not unlike the migration patterns of the painted lady butterfly. Our challenge is to evolve these networks for future generations. So we build carbon neutral warehouses. We have electrified 24,000 vehicles globally. Getting the CO2 out of this aircraft is way more complex. Also what is available today is what we call sustainable aviation fuel. But the next thing is already on the horizon, that is emission-free electric flying. We ordered the first electric cargo aircrafts already 2021. I mean, that is a big leap because now you can bridge distances of say 700-800 kilometers with an electric aircraft.
I'm placing a left throttle, accelerating to 40 knots.
I am optimistic because I see companies committing to true targets, science-based targets, and I think that can accelerate the path towards carbon zero future.